So today I will discuss about the feeding of duck and nutrient requirement of duck. What are the nutrient which is being required for feeding of duck? So first of all, I would like to say about the when we are practice less number of the duck, then there is no purposeful or special nutrient which is required. Generally, the ducks are mostly fed on a small insect, snails, and certain plant materials. And table scraps, kitchen garbage, etc. But when commercially reared ducks, then we should think about the special nutrient requirement or a special ration formulation for duck. But under such condition, means when less population of the duck or when rear the duck under the free range system, the growth performance of the duck is less. And when growth performance and overall performance is less, then laying capacity of duck is also less. So what under such condition also in free range system, we should ensure the balanced feeding and we should ensure the maximum whatever nutrient which is required for essential health and essential performance of the duck, we should provide it. Otherwise, performance may be affected. So the ration formulation and nutrient requirement depends on the population size of the duck and what purpose we are rearing the purpose of the duck, rearing of duck. There are some differences between the duck and chickens. Digestive system, if we compare with the chicken and duck, there are some differences in digestive system of duck and as compared with the chicken. That means the duck do not have crop. And due to lack of crop, the passage rate of the feed is quite higher in comparison with the chicken. So passage rate is higher, then feed consumption will be more. And duck, the proventriculus of duck is cylindrical in nature. And if you have seen the duck, then the duck did not have the beak. In like chicken, the duck have bills. And bills are which is being used for the separation of the feed mixture in the water. And they consume the feed directly from the water. And that bills by this they can remove the water when consuming the feed. And there is one problem when we offer the mass feed to the duck, then that mass feed there may be the chance of a stickiness. The mass feed got a stick with the bill, and when they got a stick, then the duck tries to shake their head or they try to find the water to remove the stickiness, and they wash the wheels so that there is the chance of lack of or chance of wastage of the feed. And once such happens, such a condition happens, then there is the economic loss as well as nutrient loss. Whatever they want, they did not get due to the nutrient which is being consumed by the duck, that is washed out with the water. So there is lack of the nutrient, there is a lack of the feed consumption, and simultaneously there is a reduction in the performance due to lack of feed consumption. And so always kept to remember that there should not be, when supplemented the feed or try to prepare the feed for duck, the mass feed should not be recommended for duck. Yes, we can feed mass, we can offer mass feed to the duck, but in wet condition, or we can mix the mass feed with water and before feeding of the duck, and then when we mix with the water, then the ducks consume very efficiently that mass feed, and which not creates problem with the bills or not a stick with the bill. But we should ensure that all the nutrients which is required for the ducks maintenance, growth and reproduction, that should be present in the ration. So now coming to the nutrient requirement of duck as per National Research Council 1994. So ME requirement for duck is up to 2 beak of age, 2900 kilocalorie per kg. From 2 to 7 beak of age, 3000 kilocalorie, and breeding under breeding condition, 2900 kilocalorie. Like that protein, it varies from the 22% in early stage of the life, then 2 to 7 week of age, 16%. That means when the age of the duck increases, the protein concentration decreases. And in breeding condition, 15% protein is required. Like lysine, 0.9% in early stage of life, then 0.65 and 0.6%. Like that calcium, 0.65, 0.6, and in breeding condition around 3% calcium is required when the ducks start laying the eggs. That means when the duck age is around 22 weeks of age, then we should offer around 3% of the calcium for optimum production of egg. So what are the feed steps which are being used for duck ration preparation? Actually, whatever the ingredients required for poultry or chicken ration formulation, that ingredient we can also use for preparation of duck ration. And but there may be some differences, and we have to take some precautions then while preparing the duck ration. Like duck are most susceptible to aflatoxin. When compared with the chicken, duck are most susceptible, around 10 times more susceptible. And you can see that the duck can tolerate up to 0.03 ppm of aflatoxin in comparison with the chicken, while chicken can tolerate up to 0.2 ppm of aflatoxin. So duck are very much susceptible to aflatoxin, and two major ingredients like GNC and mage. So both are very much susceptible to aflatoxin. So while preparing the ration for duck, these two ingredients should be checked properly whether they contain aflatoxin or not. and then only we can include in the ration of these ingredient in the ration of the duck. So before including, we must ensure these ingredients are free from aflatoxins. Like another ingredient we are generally used in layer ration of poultry, like rapeseed meal, which is also potentially toxic for duck due to presence of erucic acid and goitrogenic substances, and these erucic acid, they affect the intake of the duck. So we should avoid this kind of the feed. It also contains glycosinolates. So while preparing the ration, we should avoid such kind of the feed, and we could use other ingredients while preparing the ration. So feeding of meat type of breeder ducks, you know about the different breed of duck like white Pekin, khaki Campbell, Indian runner. These are some important breeds, and feeding of meat type breeder duck, fatty acids becomes more important. And when we feed ad libitum, then there may be the chance of getting more fat deposition in the body. So before laying or at the time of laying, we should avoid ad libitum feeding of the duck. And if the duck becomes more fatty, then they directly affect the laying performance of the duck. So we should take necessary precaution while feeding the layer duck, and we should limit the feed intake by different methods. And one of the method is we should spread the feed on the ground, so over consumption will be controlled. And in case of laying breeder duck, we should ensure the calcium percentage, it should be not less than the 3% or minimum 2.75% will be required. So we should take necessary steps to ensure the calcium availability in the ration. And side by side, we should also manage the calcium phosphorus ratio that requires for the proper absorption or proper utilization of calcium in the body. But when we including the calcium source or calcium in the diet, that then we cannot, it is not necessary to include the oyster shell in addition. So we should think while preparing the ration for layer breeder duck about that. We should always provide clean water to ducks while offering the feed. And under winter condition, we should not or we should avoid the watering at night. But it depends on the temperature range. So while avoiding the watering at night, then there may be less chance of maintaining, or there may be less chance of litter problem. And we should get the dry litter condition while we are not offering the water at night. But when temperature increases, then we should offer water at night also. So it is solely depend on the temperature, what is the temperature of the environment and what condition we are rearing the duck. So by that way we can keep the litter dry. And duck requires water for swimming. So if possible, then we should offer the duck for swimming, which is beneficial, particularly under the hot weather or hot climatic condition. That will increase the performance of the duck. So how much feed ducks consume generally? When ducks are under 0 to 1 week of age, they consume around 0.15 kg or 150 gram, we can say, daily. And the cumulative feed intake is 150 gram. Like that, in up to 7 week of age, the cumulative feed intake of duck is around 8 kg. So feed intake is higher when compared with the chicken, because size of the duck is also means higher in comparison with the chicken. And the requirement is also variable. The if we talk about the feed conversion efficiency of the duck, so the feed conversion ratio of the duck is around 2.5 to 3:1. So it is the ducks consuming more feed in comparison with the body weight. So preparation of feed for duck. Actually, duck generally prefer pellet feed, but we can offer mass feed with water, or bait mass feed we can feed to the duck. But the mass feed, when feeding to the duck with water, then just before feeding, we can mix the water with the mass feed and offer to the duck. And immediately we can offer to the duck just after mixing with the water. So it looks like a thick mass, and without making water, we should take while preparing that food, we should take precaution. We should not use much water. So feed should not become watery. Otherwise, loss of nutrient may be possible while mixing the feed with water. So that should be avoided. Otherwise, the pellet feed is more suitable for duck feeding, and the nutrient utilization and performance of pellet feed of her duck will be better always than compared with the mass feed. And while rearing commercial or while during commercial feeding practices for commercial duck production, generally recommended pellet feed. And because there is no selective feeding while pelleting the feed or offering the feed, pellet feed, no selective feeding, and there is a less chance of wastage of the feed, and total whatever the nutrient required for duck will be complete through pellet feed, and it will there is no chance of any deficiency of the nutrient while feeding the pellet feed, because there is less chance of loss of the nutrient. So pellet feed will be always preferred, and the size of the pellet is generally for younger ducks or newly hatched ducklings, the pellet size should be 4 mm in diameter and around 8 mm length. So the size of the pellet is very much important. It depends on the age of the duck. In younger age or earlier stage of the life, it should be 4 into 8 mm. And when the age is increasing, that means after 2 week of the age, they can consume around 5 mm of diameter and around 13 mm length. So by that way, different size of the pellet we can offer to the ducks for optimum production of the duck. So always prefer feeding pellet feed. In duck, generally those ducks which are feeding on pond, or they are feeding on generally fish like that, so there may be the chance of contamination of methyl mercury. You know, the mercury is a pollutant or heavy metals which is coming from the industry or several sources of mercury. So these mercury are generally adsorbed by the surface of water or sediments which is present in the ponds or tunnels. So duck are generally feeding on those under extensive system. They're feeding on tunnels and ponds like that. So there may be the chance of intake of methyl mercury, because these methyl mercury is being produced by the several kind of the reaction which happens and during the sunlight or photosynthesis. There are different kind of the algae which is present in the pond, and those algae is being fed by the small fish, and that a small fish or even algae that may be consumed by the duck. Those ducks, they feed on water, and by that way that methyl mercury, which is organic form of the mercury, that mercury is being converted by different sulfate reducing bacteria which is present in the pond, or by different algae they utilize those mercury during the photosynthesis. So when these kind of the feed they consumed by the duck, there may be the chance of deposition of methyl mercury in the tissues, different tissues. And you know, mercury is not easily excreted from the body. So under such condition, there may be the chance of contamination of duck meat with that methyl mercury. And when the human consumes that duck meat or eggs, so that methyl mercury come to the human body chain. So this is a problem. And you know about the one Minamata disease which occurs in Japan, and that occurs due to the feeding of seafoods. So those seafood contains high quantity of methyl mercury. So like that ducks when old pond and the pond where no recycling of the water properly, and tunnels are going to the pond. So such pond, they contains more amount of the methyl mercury and heavy metals. So we should avoid feeding or preferring those area for the duck for safety issue. So this is all about the duck feeding, and thank you very much.